In this video, I'll explain what annealed oligo cloning is, and I will also show you how to simulate this in Snapgene. I will firstly give you an overview of annealed oligo cloning. If you'd like more details, or to follow along, click the link for the protocol on Addgene's website. Annealed oligo cloning is a technique used to modify a plasmid through the addition of short pieces of DNA. To perform annealed oligo cloning, you must first design a pair of complementary oligos that contain the sequence you want to insert into the vector. The oligos are usually designed so that they contain overhangs when they are annealed. These overhangs should be compatible with the overhangs on the vector after it is digested with the corresponding restriction enzymes. For example, once these oligos are annealed, the left overhang will be compatible with a vector digested with the enzyme ECHO-R1, and the right overhang will be compatible with a vector digested with SAL-1. To increase the efficiency of ligation further down the line, it is recommended to add phosphates to the 5' ends of the oligos. It is also recommended to phosphatase treat your cut vector. I will go into more detail about this shortly. Adding 5' phosphates to oligos can be specified when ordering them from a manufacturer, or you can perform them enzymatically later. Then once you have the phosphorylated oligos, the next step is to anneal them together. This is generally achieved by mixing equimolar concentrations of oligos in annealing buffer, heating to around 95 degrees Celsius for a few minutes, and then allowing the mixture to cool to room temperature. With the annealed oligos now ready, the next step is to digest and purify the vector using the restriction enzymes of interest. Usually, this is achieved through an agarose gel extraction. For more information on agarose gel extraction, check out the Addgene video tutorial. Once the vector is purified, it is then recommended to phosphatase treat the vector to prevent self-ligation. Since the vector will no longer contain 5' phosphates after the phosphatase treatment, it is important that the annealed oligos contain 5' phosphates, which was earlier specified in the tutorial. The next step is to perform a ligation reaction with the linearized vector and the annealed oligo. This is usually achieved by performing a ligation reaction with a molar ratio of the linearized vector to annealed oligo between 4:3 and 1:6. This reaction is then transformed into competent bacteria to propagate. Finally, colonies can then be picked for plasmid sequence verification through sequencing to ensure the correct sequence is present. For further information about plasmid sequence verification, check out the other video tutorial. I will now demonstrate how you can use Snapgene to plan and simulate an annealed oligo cloning procedure. Within Snapgene, I have a file containing the PBR322 plasmid. What I want to do is to add three new restriction sites, PAC1, ASC1, and MFE1, between the region that is flanked by ECHO-R1 and HindI-3. To do this, I will firstly create a pair of oligos containing the new restriction sites and simulate the annealing process. For this, I will go to Actions, Anneal Oligos. In the new window, I will enter the sequence for my top oligo. Specifically, this sequence contains the restriction sites for PAC1, ASC1, and MFE1 in tandem. Note, if you're unsure about what the sequences are for certain restriction sites, you can browse the restriction site sequences directly within Snapgene. To do this, go to Enzymes, Restriction Enzymes. You can search the enzyme database by name or by using the scrolling menu. If I search for PAC1, you can see that the restriction site is TTAA-TTAA, which is the sequence I have at the start of my top oligo. For the other oligo, I will copy and paste the same sequence as the top oligo. Then I will click the reverse complement button to get the reverse complement sequence. As you can see, Snapgene has detected my three restriction sites of interest. The next step is to create the overhangs so that the annealed oligos will be compatible with my vector. To do this, type in the enzyme in the box underneath, or you can use this as a drop-down menu. So I need the left end to be compatible with ECHO-R1. I will search for this and click the Add Overhang button. I also need the right end to be compatible with Hindi-3. Doing this will create compatible overhangs, but it will also remove the Echo R1 and Hindi-3 sites. To keep a site in the final vector, I will need to modify the sequence slightly. For example, I want to keep the Echo R1 site in the final vector, but remove the Hindi-3 site. By clicking on Echo R1 in the bottom dialog box, this will open up the Echo R1 details in the restriction enzyme window. I can see that I need to add a C base at the fifth position of the top oligo. I will also need to add a complementary G base to the 3' end of the bottom oligo. Now the Echo R1 site will remain in the final vector. Since I want to remove the Hindi-3 site, I can just leave this overhang as default. Finally, as explained earlier in this tutorial, I will tick the 5' phosphorylated option for both oligos, since I will be using a linearized vector that has been phosphatase treated. Before simulating the annealing process, I will rename the file Annealed Oligos, and then click the Anneal button. The next step is to simulate the restriction and insertion cloning reaction. Simulating restriction and insertion cloning in SnapGene is discussed in more detail in a separate video tutorial, but I will briefly show you how this is done. To simulate the insertion cloning, I will go to Actions, Restriction and Insertion Cloning, Insert Fragment. In the first tab, I will select the file containing my vector, which is PBR322. On the map view, I need to select the two restriction enzymes that will be used in the reaction. This will be Echo R1 and Hindi-3. So I will shift-click on the Echo R1 and Hindi-3 sites. In the next tab, I will select the recently created file containing the annealed oligos as my source of insert. Finally, in the product tab, I can preview the final product. Here you can see the annealed oligos, in this case in red, and the vector in black. At the bottom, you can see that the overhangs in the annealed oligos bind to the complementary ends of the vector that was digested with Echo R1 and Hindi-3. I will now click on the clone button to simulate the restriction and insertion cloning. Now I have a multiple cloning site containing Echo R1, PAC1, ASC1, and MFE1. And that's the end of this tutorial. In this video, you have learned about the steps involved in annealed oligo cloning and how to use SnapGene to quickly simulate this technique. For more information about annealed oligo cloning, including a protocol, check out the Addgene website. To download SnapGene to simulate oligo annealing and restriction cloning, then head on over to the SnapGene website.